Hello students, now continuation of previous video. Sum number 6 I have shown you, 7 also with the help of 6 you can do yourself. Number 8, one sum I am showing how to do. Same type, that's why one method I am showing. Let us calculate what term should be added to both terms of the ratio 3:5 to make the ratio 6:1. Okay, so first we will write down, let x should be added. Let x should be added with both the terms. So what will be my equation to both the terms of 2y? So 2 plus x by 5 plus x, the ratio will become 6:11. Here now cross multiply and calculate the value of x. 22 plus 11x, 30 plus 6x, or 11x minus 6x equals to 30 minus 22, or 5x equals to 8. So x is coming 8/5. So what will be your answer? 8/5 should be added with both the terms of the ratio 2:5. Clear? So number 2 also you can do yourself, and number 3 also you can yourself. Basically 5.1 exercise is very easy. Now we will go to the next exercise, that is there is in class 8 also you have done how to calculate the third proportional, fourth proportional, mean proportional. Again, I am doing that. Exercise 5.2. Find the fourth proportional of the following. How to find out fourth proportional? I am doing sum number 4. This is little bit hard, that one. That's why I am doing p minus q, p square minus q square, and given p square minus p q plus q square. There are three terms. In these two, you have to calculate the fourth proportional. Yeah. So I am considering A. A B the fourth proportional. Let X be the fourth proportional. Therefore, what we can write? P minus Q by p square minus q square equals to p square minus p q plus q square by unknown term, that x unknown variable will be here. Now you know how to calculate this. So x will be this into that, p square minus q square into p square minus p q plus q square by this p minus q. Clear? Now this is a square minus b square form, a plus b into a minus b. What is left? P plus Q into P square minus P Q plus Q square. I am 100% sure that if I ask this, what formula it is? 70% students will give wrong answer. Here, P plus Q into P square minus PQ plus Q square. This is the formula of PQ plus Q cube. Okay. In class 8 you have learned, and every year in class 9 also I have to say same formula, and class 10 also during exam time also you ask, ma'am, what is the formula of PQ minus PQ? What is the formula of A plus B whole cube? Yeah. In class 8, what you have learned, you have to memorize this. This is the method of finding fourth proportion. Now, how to calculate third proportion? X minus y whole square given, and x square minus y square whole square. So we write down it, the third proportional be x. Clear? So in finding of third proportional, it will come twice. Second term will come twice. So my don't write x. Okay, already x is in your problem. So I am writing let it be p. So x minus y whole square by x square minus y square whole square equals to x square minus y square whole square by p. So p is unknown, you have to calculate p. P is x square minus y square whole square into x square minus y square whole square by x minus y whole square. Clear? Now from here you will get x, I am opening, x plus y whole square is here into x minus y whole square, and there is also x plus y whole square. Yeah, and denominator x minus y whole square. So one this will be cancelled. So what we are getting, x plus y whole to the power 4 into x minus y whole square. So one thing I can write in that form also. See, x plus y whole square, x minus y whole square. So we can write x square minus y square whole square, and there is x plus y whole square. Yeah, this is the third proportional. Finding, this is the method of finding third proportional. Now mean proportional. Now how to find out mean proportional?
So we can write it in that form, x square
Y square. Therefore, M is coming X square. So your answer is the mean proportional is X square Y square. Objective. SAQ part, find out the mean proportional, find out the fourth proportional, or what term should be added to, what should be added to each term of the given ratio so that the new ratio will become this, this, this. Clear? Now, this is the most important chapter. Exercise 5.3. How to do? It is given A by B. Equals to C by D. It is given. Clear? Now you have to find out. You have to find out the value of this A square B square is to A square minus B square. Clear? Now we are considering A by B equals to C by D equals to K, where K not equals to zero. Therefore, A equals to BK and C equals to DK. Clear? What ratio will be given from there, we will consider K. Clear? K is a non-zero variation. You have to write down K not equals to 0. So, from here, we are considering this equal to K. So, A is coming BK, C is coming DK. Now, you have to prove this is to this equal to that, that is to that. So left hand side first we calculate left hand side. Okay. Left hand side A square plus B square by A square minus B square. A will express in terms of B. So B square A square plus B square. Here also B square A square minus B square. Now take B square common, so K square plus 1. Here also take B square common, K square minus 1. This and this will. Now see, K square plus 1 by K square minus 1. This is total constant term. Clear? So write down here constant. Clear? Now we will do right hand side. Let's see what is coming in right hand side. Right hand side is AC plus BD by AC minus BD. Now, what you do? You will convert A. Okay, there is BD. Here BD. So here we convert A in terms of B, C in terms of B. So BD you can take common. Here A in terms of B and C in terms of D. Plus BD. Here also A in terms of B and C in terms of D minus BD equals to BD K square and BD. So BD take common. It is coming K square plus 1 and denominator BD take common K square minus 1. Cancel out. So we are getting this equals to K square plus 1 by K square minus 1. Now see, same constant. Here K square plus 1 by K square minus 1. We have got same constant. So from here, we can conclude that left hand side equals to right hand side. Here, therefore, left hand side equals to right hand side. In this way, we have to do. So what is the method? This is clear, I think so. This is given. We will consider let this equals to constant, non-zero constant K. Now from here we are getting A equals to this, C equals to that. Then left hand side put the values of A in terms of B we are getting. B will be cancelled out, we are getting constant. And right hand side, both A and C convert in terms of B and B. So again, after putting also here, we are getting same constant. So we can write now left hand side equals to right hand side. Once I have done, 2 and 3 will practice same method, you will give the answer. Clear? Now next sum you will get it next video.